Good morning, welcome to Emerging Techno Degree class. We are now in week 3 and we will study about layout and widget. There are two sections for layout and widget. This one still on the part 1 and next week we will move to the part 2. Because there is a lot of layout widget and layout and widget, there are a lot of layout and widget, and with 2 weeks we still not cover all of that, but we will learn about the commonly used ones. So maybe you can try to learn by yourself the rest one. Okay. Please open our project, our previous project, and running it first. Okay, in emulator or in device. Our previous project. In our previous project, we already have some screen here. We have board, and we already taken a picture from network. Take a picture from network in a board and also in this one in the drawer. We have studied about navigation bar here. Bottom navigation bar and how to replace the screen in the, when we click the navigation button, and also when we click the menu in the drawer here, my basket. Also, we already studied about how to send parameter to the screen. For example, this one, we have 2 items, item 1 and item 2. Item 2. In your homework, you already create a list of students that consists of 3 students here. And when you click one of them, you pass ID and showing the picture, the photo of the student. Okay. Now we will move to layout. Okay, before moving to layout, in Flutter, we already know about widget actually, but we can compare widget to Lego block. We can add on the block together and create an object, and the object can be adding with the different kind of block and make another block. So widget similar with Lego blocks. We can create blocks from blocks. We can create another block from another block. In Android Studio, we get new facility, new feature here. Open your Android Studio and click this one, Flutter menu in the left side. There are Flutter menu here. This one. This is the Flutter widget tree. Widget tree is a structure that represents how our widgets are organized. For example, our main. This one, there are main function here. main function calling the my app. My app calling the my home page. My home page is stateless. My app is stateless. My home page is stateful. Okay. As it's stateful, it have private underscore page state. Yeah. And in the page state, it have counter, variable counter, variable my emoji from our first week. Also the emoji and current index from our previous week. Also, we have screens from our previous week related with index. There are increment counter from default Flutter project here. Okay, and we put drawer here. We put drawer. In the drawer, we have header, like header, user account drawer header here. There are text name. This one, if you click this one, source code here will be positioned. For example, the circle avatar, this one, like build, this one will be position object that we click. For example, again, there are two menu here, list title. Menu ya. Title 1, title 2, this one, title 3. This style. And then the bottom navigator ya. Bottom navigator. Okay. And then the main content, the build, there are scaffold here. Yeah. Scaffold consists of a bar and above of the content, and there are floating action button and another button here. Okay, this is a Flutter widget tree. Okay, if we have many widgets in our screen, it will be easier for us to finding where to find certain widget here. Okay. Next, we will study about a layout widget. There are two type of layout widget, single child and multi child. We already learn several of it. For example, in about, for example, there are center, this one. Center is a single child layout widget, single child. It have just one child here. Okay, in main, we already study column. Where is the column? Fine. This one. Column is one of multi-child layout widget. Multi-child layout widget because it can be it can have more than one child, and in the properties it will not use child but using children. It will using children, and there are list of widget. There are a list of widget Sometimes we not need to casting here, not need to casting here. This also running well. Okay. This is list or array in other language programming. This is calling array, but in Flutter, it call list. Okay, there is a list of widget in children because this one column is a multi-child layout widget. Okay, another for example, I will searching children. They will get column. I think we just the one layout, one single multi-layout widget. Just the column and the child. Actually, for child, for using child, we not need not just a single child layout widget, but another widget actually have also the child. Usually have child, for example. We will try to check the child. This one, floating action button also have child. The child is icon. Floating action button is a widget, but not layout widget. Actually, not layout widget, but it can also have a child. Another elevated button also. Okay. Next, okay. This one is a list of single child layout widget taken from Flutter documentation. We will open Flutter documentation first. Flutter layout widget. Okay, this one. I will put the link in chat. Single child layout widget. There are align. Align is for aligning children within itself. There are optional size and it use position name. This is left, bottom. We will see next. Left, right, or but top, bottom, or upper, lower. I don't remember. Okay, or we can also put it by fraction. The top left is -1, and top bottom right is 1. I think we will see. And then there are aspect ratio here, and maybe this is not commonly used, but align is commonly used. And we already use center here. A simple widget layout for centering child. Also, there are constraint block here, another widget. Based on constraint, and the most common use is container. With container, we can create a center, we can create constraint box, we can also create maybe just like a line, but not using the property in line, but we can also put by padding, setting the padding of the child container, most commonly use a single widget, single child widget layout. Okay, another there are expanded, filter, okay, overflow, padding. If we want to put the children based on the padding of the children with the container, the parent. And there are transformation. We will study the transformation widget in the last week, I think, about animation. Sorry, the last week before UTS. Not last week of the classes. First, we will try the align widget. We will try the align widget. Padding, size book, and form. This is another. Actually, you can see a little explanation with video in where is the explanation video in some in this documentation. For example, a line. There are video here. Introduction of the align widget. Okay, and also another widget. Sometimes there are video of that introduction of the widget. Okay, we will try several of this, and in first, maybe we will try to use align layout widget first. Okay, align layout is a widget that align its children, its child, sorry, its child within itself. Optional size, there we can use a size for the children, and we can put the children based on the position name, bottom center of this one, bottom, and using top and bottom, right and right, left and right, and the center, bottom center, bottom right, bottom left, center, center left, center right, top center, top right, top right, top left. Okay, I repeat, bottom center is here, bottom center, bottom right, bottom left, center, center left, center right, top center, top right, top left. Okay, or we can use fraction value. For example, this one. Zero is in the center. 0,0 is here. Top left will be minus one, comma minus one. Bottom right is 1,1. Yeah. 1,1. 0,0 here. You can use a fraction here. For example, 0,2, 0,8, 6. For example, yeah. So I think this one will put it some place here. Sampai sih. We will try it. Maybe we will modify the bot for using for trying this one. For example, this one. Put it in a bot. Okay. Put it in a bot. For example, we put it here. We still use center here. I think we will create several widget here. We will try several widget here. So change the center with column. So we can use several children here. For example, we use align with top center, aligning with the name of the position top center. Okay. This one. Now we put in the chat. Please replace the body with this one. Body. Okay, we modify the center with column because we will use several different widget here. And for the first, we will try the align widget. Okay, we align with top center here. What is align? It will align the text widget bla 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 ya. Okay. Refresh or reload and then open the about under about ya. This one bla 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 in position of top center. Sorry. Okay. Okay, bla bla bla. For example, we put it in bottom center. Bottom center, there is no bottom center. Center bottom ya. So B, little B ya. Bottom center. Still in here. Okay, I think because sorry, we have to put some size for the parent. For example, we put container something ya, container, put container first. Some layout widget, it need a size. A widget, example widget that have a size is a container widget. Container widget. So put container first. And for example, we can set the height. Container key alignment hik ada kok hik 200 with child, the child is aligned here. Sorry. And this is the container, this one. Okay, we'll try it again. Okay, this one. For example, we put a color in a container, so we can see where is the container boundaries. Colors. Ember. Okay, this one. This is the color, sorry, the container boundaries with ember, ember color. We put the text. We put the text in bottom center, yeah, bottom center. Okay, for example, can bottom top left, for example, top right, top right, and then reload. This one put it. Okay, also we can put in a fraction. In fraction, we can create alignment here and the fraction of x for x and for the y. Alignment 0,0 is a center. 0,0 is a center. Okay, look. Minus is in the left and minus for y is in the top. For example, minus 0.5, minus 0.5. It will place here, I think. Okay, refresh it. Yes. Okay. You can try another position. We put this one to the chat body and until this one. Okay. Okay, if you have trouble or error or something, you can just chat, not need to waiting the question and answer session. Next. Okay, this is a line layout. We can grab some element, for example, in this element we use text. We can wrap another element also, for example, like our previous picture. we can put the picture in some place here. Okay, and next there are aspect ratio layout. This one will be a time the size of the child in specific ratio. Based on the size of width, so it's expressed with width to height. Width to height. For example, the parent have a size 200 and 200. We create the aspect ratio with 4 to 1, 4 to 1. So the width will be four times larger than the column. The height. The width 4 times than the height here. The height is here. Height of the container in the child. It have 4 times. Larger, 4 times larger than the height. Okay, this one is the opposite. The width is 1/4 larger, a quarter larger than the width here. We can copy it. And put it in here. Oops. This one, there are container child here with aspect ratio 4 to 1. It mean it the width is four times then the height. If we change it, for example, 3 to 1, it will be height. Hacker have more hack here. And for example, 2 by 1. This is just the same with 2, sorry. For example, if this one is 20, this one is 10. 2 to 1. The opposite, if we create 1 to 4, the container in the child will like this one. If we create 1 to 1, I think it because this is actually a rectangle, a box with the same width and height, it will be filling the parent. Okay, the container actually have also another property that relate with the child. For example, padding here. We can use padding if we have just If we just using a padding attribute, we can use padding here. Padding. You already see the padding in here, I think this one. With container, actually we can also use act like this one. Container can act like padding, can also act like center, I think center. Okay, there is padding here. For example, we can put I think there are another slide about padding, but for padding it will need inset. Adds inset. It will not need add inset. For example, use adds inset dot all with some value here. Nanti. From all side, left, right, top, and bottom, it have padding 20. So it become like this one. There are padding here for top, bottom, left, and right. Okay, this one with ratio, aspect ratio, for example, we put it again. Okay, this one. Okay, this is our second, third, I think, and container. Our third single child layout widget. Okay, we will continue about container. We already use padding here. And in container, if we want to make something more style, we can use decoration. The container first surround the child with padding, surrounding the child with padding. Okay, the child will not use the padding rinse here. And then, for example, if there are decoration or something, it will be inflated in border. And then apply Adena constraint. And there are margin also for positioning the container within its parent. For example, here this is another widget. We can set margin. For example, we want to use. If we want to create some space here, we can use margin top, for example here, margin top. Okay. And there are additional property for using padding and margin. It's called adds inset class. Adds inset. We already used the all edge inset here. Okay. And also we can create one by one here with edge inset only. From the left and the top, right or bottom. You can use only mean it will be running the padding in the position that you just put it here. If you not put the top, for example, the top will be zero. If you not put the right will be zero, also the bottom. If you just put the left, so the padding will be only act in the left, in the left side. Also, if you want to create different padding, but in symmetric, horizontal and vertical, you can use symmetric. So, symmetric mean vertical, it mean left and the top, and horizontal mean you put the left and the right, the left and the right with the same size here. Okay, we will try again another container here. Okay, I think we already have a container. We can create this one. We can just modify again this one. Okay. For example, margin color. We can. We also have. We already have color here. We will try the margin first. We put a margin here. Margin also create with edge inserts. Edge insert, for example, we just put the only for the top, for example, top. This one, top. For top, I put 20 here. So there will be a distance from the container and another container in the top of this container. Okay, there will be a space in this one. There will be a space here. This is a margin. Okay, margin ready done. Padding also already. We can create also the symmetric one or using the only like this one. For example, for the padding, if we create the only like this one, only. So there will be only padding in the parameter we create, for example, left 30, and another side top left and sorry top bottom and right will be zero. Okay. This one. Oh, I think it will be easier for us to see if the children will have aspect ratio 1:1. Nah, this one. This is 30, but because it have 1:1, the aspect for the aspect ratio widget, so the children will be of the same height and width. It have a full width first, and then the height also have the same size with the height width. So, and if we put, for example, symmetric, this one. Symmetric, in symmetric, there are parameter horizontal and vertical. For example, we use vertical, it 30 also. There will be space between, but I think because we use one by one, there is something like padding, but it's not padding. I will show you. This one. Just like padding, but not padding because we use aspect ratio here. Okay. I think it's better if we use another container for this. For example, using cart, I think. So the cart will be filling fully in the container. If we use aspect ratio, it will not fill the parent with full of the size. Okay. Okay, another this one margin and the child is card. Look in the card, there is a text, and we put symmetric for horizontal, and we'll put it higher than this. Symmetric for the horizontal is 30. For example, the vertical is 0. So it will be like this one. Okay, this one. For example, we create the vertical one here. Refresh. This one symmetric edge, symmetric padding in vertical. This is a container. In container, we also can create a decoration. The decoration need a book decoration class. The book decoration class provide a variety which to draw a book. It have a border. It also have a box shadow. It have shape. We can create a circle or a rectangle. In rectangle, we can create a rounded rectangle with border radius property. Okay. And then we can also create the image, image of some like background image for the decoration box. Decoration image, okay. This one. That's a commonly used property in the box decoration. Border. Border radius is if we create the shape with rectangle box shape. If we create rectangle, it will be related with border radius. Then box shadow can create a shadow color and gradient and image. We will try some of these properties. Okay. Okay, we still use image from pravata.cc here. We create a container with height and width, so 40. We create a decoration here. The decoration have image and taken from network image in pravata. and there's fit here. If you have a different size of image rather than the size of the container, it can be cover or clip or something here in the box fit properties. And there are a border here from the a container. But we may have some warning sign here because we already have, maybe we have a container outside the screen. If we create another screen, we will create another container that outside the screen here. Okay, but we can resolve it with this one, single child scroll view. Okay, put this one first, and then we will resolve the warning here. Okay, put it in another container. Save, reload. There are error in this one. There are error in here. Overflowing. The subject render form is overflowing. Lebih gitu ya. The size bla 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 overflow. Not error actually, but warning. But we have to cover this this warning, I think, because this is very very bad for user. Okay, for base of this, we have to put the name is single child scroll view. Single child scroll view. Actually, this is like a widget. Widget that maybe not listed that in the our previous list. It create the container that can scroll if the size raise more than the screen size, it will automatically can scroll it. So we put the column, wrap the column with this one. We have a column in our root here. So wrap the column with this one, single child scroll view. And the column become the child. And don't forget to put the sign, the closer sign here. This one, close sign. Reload, and the warning already gone. We can scroll it. Okay. I will put again the body, I think. I will put the body again in chat. nggak bisa. Nggak bisa di copy. Apa ya? Terlalu panjang kan. I think it's also simple. I think you can create it by yourself. Put a single child scroll view in for the root of the body. And the column become child here. Become child. And you have to put the close of the single child scroll view in the bottom. Okay, if you have any difficulties, please chat. Okay. For now, our upload will be like this one. Sometimes if we want to create some space, for example, with the bottom, so what we see will not in the very bottom from the screen. We can put divider here. Divider with some height. We have some space here with divider. Okay. I will more detail about the decoration. This is a container here, is 400 and height 400, and there are border here with indigo color. This one is indigo color. Indigo color here, and the width of the decoration border is 10. This is the width of this one, this border. If we want to create more wider border, we just put the higher value here. This one. And there are fit here, for example, our image is higher, for example, more than the have a size more than the container size. Maybe we put this one. This is the size from Fravatar that we can set. So now the picture that we taken from this website is have a size 800 900 900. Reload. Okay, there is no different because we use with cover here, with cover. There are another choices here, for example, with okay, cover content. They have no different because the image have a rectangle size. I think also we cannot create the fit height and fit width because we already use the same size. Okay, maybe in the container we put another container size ya. Okay, this one. This is fit height, so it will put the height. I think I will lower first. Okay, this will fit for the height first, but because the height and the width of the picture is the same. Okay, it will like this one. Jadi, yang mengikuti tinggi maksimumnya. If we change, sorry, if we change with the fit, height, sorry, fit width. This one. Fit. Okay, will become like this one. Okay, you can try another property here. cover contain. Contain mean all images must be contained in the parent. Because sometimes we not know the size of the image. So it just contained the image. Or cover, for example, cover, it will have to cover all the size of the container. Okay. Actually, like the fit width, but sometimes we cannot decide. We use fit width or we use fit height. So we can, if we cannot decide, we just put the cover here. If we use cover and the container. For example, have another size here. It still cover the container. Still cover the container. Okay. This is about the fit in the box decoration, decoration image here. Okay. I will put it back again. Okay. And I will use another property slide. This one, we can use box shape circle here. Box shape circle. Circle. Box shape circle. This one. Have a circle. Circle decoration. Okay. We also can use rectangle. Rectangle. So, rectangle like on our previous one, but in rectangle we can use another property related with rectangle for rounding the rounding the rectangle. It use bottom, sorry, border radius. This one. Border radius. We can use for the radius all, for example, for all radius is the same, have the same radius. All sides have the same radius. For example, sorry. We have to create all in this one first. What it call radius circular. Circular. Radius circular. Radius circular mean in X and Y, it will be in the same radius. All mean all of the side. All mean all of the side. We will create radius in here, in here, and in here. It means this one all. And for the radius, this is the y, and this is the x. Yeah. If we use circular radius, it will have the same x and y. This one with some value. Yeah. For example, 30. Kurungnya kurang. Ya, kurungnya kurang satu. Oke. This is radius 30. If we want higher radius, for example, 100, it will be become like this one. Sorry. The radius is the same in X and Y. We can create another radius if we not want the same radius for X and Y. For example, elliptical, this one. We put the X, for example, for 30, and the Y is 100. 30 and 100. So the X will be just have radius from here, but in the Y, maybe some have a portion until this one. So it will be like this one. This one. The X portion is 30 and the Y portion is 100. Another example, for example, 100 and 200. Okay, this one 100 and 200. Also, we can create the opposite. The x higher than the y. Like this one. Okay. We also can use radius not for all, not for all like this one. We just create the radius, for example, just for the left one. Radius dot only for the top left. We get radius only from the top left with radius circular, for example. Okay. So the radius will be just reset here. Another is still in in a vertex like not have a radius. Okay, like this one. Okay. Like this one. We can also create another radius in the here, top left and top left, comma. Oh, already specified. Use right left. Top right, sorry. Top right. Okay. Top left and top right, for example. So it will become like this one. Or top left and bottom right. It will become like this one. Okay. So you can create with another style. Okay, for example, one can we can create like a circle but with sudut ya, pakai sudut left top left top right. Nah. Okay, this is for order radius. Okay, and we can also create the shadow here, box shadow. Create box shadow, for example, with blur radius and with color black. Jadi namanya box shadow. Box shadow, I think we have to put it in. Where's the to put the box shadow? Box shadow. Box shadow. With a blue radius. Oh, box shadow has a property with list of box shadow. I'll show you this one, list of box shadow. So it can be used for more than one box shadow. We can use more than one box shadow. So we have put this one and then it use in blue radius or blue radius and color offset blue radius color. So radius, for example, 30 and color black. Colors black. Okay. And it will come like this one. Okay, this is about the container, and the container is our last example for one single child. Our last example for single child. Next, we move to the multi-child layout widget. Okay, there are several common widget that we can use: column, row, stack, grid view, and list view. For this, we will learn about row, stack, and grid view. I think the list view will be continue next week. Okay, another multi-child, there's custom multi-child flow, wrap table, etc. Okay, about column, actually we already use column here. We create a column widget for display children vertically, like this one. We already put the children vertical. Just put that in the list. And the column will create another widget vertically. Okay. You can use cross axis, main axis, and axis alignment and axis size. We will apply this property in row. Just the same property, but different direction. Okay. Row is used for displaying the children in horizontally. Okay. It will display horizontally. Just the same with the column, but horizontally. We can also create the alignment and the axis size and extra here. Okay, this is about the main axis property. In the row, the main axis is the horizontal one and cross axis is the vertical one. The opposite in the column. Okay. This one, we will tying one of several of this property. There are main axis alignment property here. Start, if we want to put from the start, and if we want to put the children of the rows in the end. Center and space between, space evenly, and there's also space around. Okay. We will learn it by an example here. Put three of picture again from Pravatar. Okay. Put from Pravatar. In for the default, it will be used axis alignment start. Okay. Axis alignment start will put from start. If we use axis alignment end, it will be reset here first. If we use main axis alignment center, it will just like this one. Space around like this one. space between this one and space evenly like this one. Okay. Okay, put this one in okay, another point like this one. Okay, put it before the divider after our last box decoration. Okay, we can use a space between our container with divider. For example, I will use divider with height 30 here. Okay. There are three images with size 100. This one. This is for main axis alignment default. Axis alignment default is with an axis alignment start. Main axis alignment start. This is the default. No different with this one. And we use N, for example, an axis alignment N. Okay, this will reset in the end of the main axis. If we use another property here, space around, space between, or center, center, it will be placed in the center. And another one, space around. Space around like this one. There are space around its children. Space evenly. Space evenly. And space between. Space between will filling the container. This one. It will reset in the start, it will reset in the end. And another rest in the middle, space between. Okay. Again, if we create more than the screen size, for example, we put another, okay, we put another row here. We put another row with 6 images. We put after our first row, this is our second row. Okay, there are 6 images here. So if the image, if we sum the image width, it will be 600, and it will be more than our screen size. Our screen size, and we will get another error here. Warning sign. Okay. The screen scrolling. Okay. Screen scrolling. Yes, now for Besok teh we have to create the screen single single chat scroll view this one. Okay, grab our row or our column in single chat scroll view. Okay. But by default, it will have a vertical scrolling. So for column, for rows, we have to put scroll direction with axis horizontal. So it will be scroll horizontally because the default is scroll vertically. This one we not use any property here, just wrap the column with single tab scroll view. Okay, doing like this, like that one, we can wrap the row here with single child scroll view. Well, child is this row. Don't forget to put the close parenthesis in here. But because it horizontally scrolls, we have to put another property for scroll direction. Scroll direction equal to axis horizontal. Okay, rerun, and then the warning sign is removed, and we can scroll this one. You can add another image here without worries. And F. Okay, I will put this one in the chat. Single chat scroll view, wrap with row wrapped with single chat scroll view. Wrap itu dibungkus ya, dibungkus. Jadi row-nya dibungkus dengan single chat scroll view. Ya. Okay. Next. If we want to create space between the image, how to create space between the image? You can put the divider here, or you can wrap each image with padding. Eh, sorry, margin apa padding. editing, edge, insert, all, five for example. This one still applied to our first photo. We are padding here. So if we want to use space in all this image, we have to wrap all this image to with a padding layout. Okay. Next, we will move to another multi-child layout widget. It calls stack. Stack will be used for put the children in stack. So each children will position it in front of another. The default is put in the top left corner, but we can align the position. Okay. For doing the stack, we will create another image. For image, there are several different type of source. We can use image asset. We can use network. We usually use this image.network in our previous example. Okay. There is also image.file if we want to open the image from file. This is different with the asset. The asset also file, but the asset will be bundled along with the code in the APK file. So in the APK file will be have a more size than if we use image file here, because it will be bundled in the APK file. All the resource on the asset will be bundled in the APK file. Also, we can open the image from memory if we use, for example, camera. When we click the camera, it's still in the memory. We can open the image with this one, image.memory. Okay. For using this example, we will use two images. We will use network image from another resource, not the Pravatar, like our previous one. We will use another dummy image. And for the second image, we will use image from ULS. We will use ULS missing.png. Missing.png. We will create an asset image here. So in stack, we will also learn about how to open the asset's image. Okay, first create a new folder here, asset image in the same directory with lib folder. This is a lib folder here. Okay, same directory with pubspec YAML also. We will modify this one. Create a new directory called assets, and then in this directory we create another directory called image. So with the same position with lib, there is asset slash images here. Okay, and open the ULS, download missing.png from the ULS, or you can also use another image. For we will create an image of cat and put the missing sign image.google.com. We will put a missing sign in front of our first image. Missing sign PNG. Okay, I take the image from this one. Okay, you can take another picture actually, but I already prepare in ULS. This one, missing.png, you can download it and put in our new directory, assets image directory. Put in our new directory. Folder, hello world. Asset image, this one. Save it here, missing.png. Okay. And for using the asset, we have to put the declaration in pubspec.yaml. We need to modify pubspec.yaml. This is a very important file. If we use plugin, we have to put also the declaration here. Also, if we use asset, okay, this one, we put in asset. Okay, we have assets. Slash image slash missing dot png here. Okay, we will check our files, assets, this one, missing dot png. Okay, don't forget to save. When save, it will be compressed and bundled in a resource. In a resource, so we have to redoing the Flutter run. If we add a new asset, we have to doing Flutter run again. So you have to finish stop the Flutter run with Control C, and then doing again the Flutter run. So the asset will be included in the project. We cannot use just code reload because this is a new asset. It will be built and put in the resource of our APK. Okay, this one, before we run it, maybe we have to, I think we have, we will modify the application first. This one, we create a stack. The stack have two children, this one from network, from network, and another image we take from asset. Image.network and image.asset. The asset will use our missing PNG files, and the network will be used Kitten kitten image taken from pleasekitten.com. This one is also provide a dummy image, but with not like the avatar. This one will use a kitten image. Okay. Pleasekitten.com. I get it from this one. Pleasekitten, there are several example we can use with a different resolution, size of the image, and also we can use an ID. I think we will use that ID in next of our slide. Okay. This one. Okay, put this one after our last example about that. Okay, I will put it here. Maybe we can create another divider first here. And put this one. Okay. Pleasekitten image 12. Okay, this one is the ID of the image. You can put 0 to 15, I think. After 15, the image still use the 15 image. Okay. I will run it again. So tech will create, we'll put the children in the same place. So it will be, our application will have a photo of kitten, and then there are missing sign in front of it. So we create assets image, yes, assets with S. In the slide is assets with S. We create it manually. Okay, open the output again. This one, missing kitten. Okay, this is from image 12, yeah. For example, image 10, we can get another kitten. Okay. Okay. The missing image reset in top left, yes. That in top left. Can you modify it? So the cat image have a rounded corner. It have a rounded corner here. And the missing text present in the bottom center. this one, paste it in the bottom center. So to modify it, so the image cat have a rounded corner. You may have to create with the border decoration, box decoration. Not create with just image network, but using a container with box decoration. And then for the missing sign, you can use a line. You can use a line. Okay. Okay, I will break for 5 minutes. Please do this exercise first before we move to our last subject about grid view. Okay, I will take on my charger first. Okay, I'm back. Okay. Can you modify it so it can have a rounded corner and the missing text placed in the bottom center? Or maybe we doing the bottom center first. Bottom center there. There is a property alignment. This one alignment. Alignment of the children. We can put the alignment to alignment. Sorry. Alignment dot top center center bottom center mungkin bottom center we can use this one alignment dot bottom center this is missing in the bottom center. And for doing a round the corner, doing the rounded corner, maybe we have to create a container, create a container like this one. And with box decoration, we put the kitten image here. And doing again border radius here. Okay, so we not use network image directly. We can use container and box decoration. Okay. I believe you can do it by yourself. Okay, we move to our last. Widget about sorry grid view. Okay, grid view is a grid widget for showing its children in a grid. It's a grid. Okay. We can use gridview.con for create a simple actually a simple grid view, a simple children in the grid view. If we use more than more complex, we can use filter here. To create grid view with large or infinite number, or maybe we use web service for the children, we can use grid view builder. If we want to create not in grid, we can use list view. List view will be explained in next meeting. Okay. Here we will use gridview.con, gridview constructor. Gridview.con is a constructor to show grid of cat image. We already know about kitten place here, place kitten here. We will place about 15 cat image in a grid. Okay, the grid view connect the children in form of list of widget. The grid view have children The children is list of widget. So we will create the list of widget with a function in a function to generate a list of widget. And then in the property of children, we will put this function. Okay. Then the view needs a parent which have a size like another widget layout. Which view need a parent, so we can we have to create a container, for example, for the parent of the grid view. So we can create it like this one, container hex, for example, container hex 400, and then we put the children of the container with grid view. We put grid view, and also we generate with its constructor method .com. We create grid with cross axis con equal to 3. There is 3 counting here for axis and for the main axis. It will depend on the number of the data. Depend on the number of the children here. The children will be taken from the function cats here. We create our function. We create our own function cats here that returning list of widgets data type. This one is for doing the create a data type list of widget. If we want to create a list of string, we create this one, list of string. So we need a list of widget. So we have to put widget here, list of widget. Okay, we initiate a widget with empty array, empty list here. We are looping one for from 0 to 15 until 15. We looping it and we create the widget taken from placeKitten.com image from image 0, image 1, image 3, image 2 until 15 here. So the temp variable will have more than one, we will have 15 image network widget here. Yeah. This is the list and it have 15 image of kittens here. Okay. Put this function. This function in some place inside about class here. Visually we put it here before the override build. Okay. This is our own function. You can create another name, for example, list of cat, for example, cat widget, for example, cats widgets. Okay, it will looping 15 times and create a image network with different parameter, image 1, image 2, image 3 until 15. Next, we create a new container with that have a great children, great child. The great have a children taken from our own function cats. Okay. Maybe we create divider also. Yeah. Okay. The container have height 500. And it have cross axis cone with three image. And the children taken from place of network image. Okay. We will reload it. And we will see. Okay, this one very cute. Okay, this is grid style. Grid style. Yeah. We can modify, for example, the cross axis cone here with two, maybe. So every row you have will just have two cat meets. But we can get more an image that have more size here. For example, if it just two, we can create an image with more than this resolution of the image. For example, one. Or also we can create more little one, and then we put hyker axis value here. This one. Okay. Okay. Actually, we also can create the image in with a border. With a border, if we create an image with a border in this function, we put not directly use in this network. We can use container here. We can use container and the box decoration. Okay. Actually, this one image with grid with rounded corner will be in it will be your own work actually, but I replace it because we have a event, an event, an international event inside 2021. Yeah. So I replace the homework, not doing this kitten image with a rounded corner, but if you can maybe you want to explore it by yourself. Please explore it by yourself. And the homework is just attending this event. You can see the program books from this one. Okay. There is an international event from faculty, from our faculty, and this one is the program book. You can decide where you, where session you can attend, where session. What session you want to attend here? There are 2 days, and in there are several parallel session here. Also, you can use, you can also attend the keynote session or parallel session. Parallel session here. And the schedule for a parallel session like this one. You can see where you are interested in, and when you attend the session, just capture the image and put it in ULS. You can attend more than one session. So if you attend more than one session, zip and upload the image in the US. Okay, think enough for now. There is no homework in programming, so the your homework is just attending and upload the capture of image where you attend. Okay. Oh, there's an error in David. Okay, David nanti agak siangan ya, capri aja. Ya, paling itu salah-salah nama file atau tempat mana YAML ya. Nah, ini kalau ada spasi ini sudah error juga ya. Jadi harus pas begini, terus folder dan image-nya harus sama. Oke, habis ini saya ada kuliah lagi soal. Is this homework must do it or not? Where's the homework? Is this homework?
The capture image, the
yes.
Last one.
Yes, you have to do it for, I think, I already explained in every week we have 10 point for UTS, and this one is one of it. So you, if you attend it, you have 10 points for UTS. Okay, thank you everyone. We will see you again next week with another widget and another layout. Thank you. Salam sehat ya.
Thank you, sir.
Sir.
Jangan lupa absen. Sudah dibuka tadi.
Thank you, sir.
Okay.